Hey everyone, it's Samantha. From a man that takes down zombies on a regular basis to the Joker's blonde sidekick, here are some Hollywood actors you never knew were foreign.
Number 17, Andrew Lincoln. This actor is most well known for his role as Rick Grimes in the zombie-infested world of The Walking Dead. Rick Grimes is a sheriff's deputy and wakes up from a coma to find that an unknown pathogen has spread across the world and turned people into the living dead.
But his Southern American accent on the show would lead you to believe that Lincoln is from the States.
You'd be surprised to find out that this given name is Andrew James Clutterbuck, and he's from London, England. There's no denying that he's a gifted actor, especially when you consider his outstanding American impressions. If you watch a bit of his other work, like his part in Love Actually, then you'll hear his British accent. So how'd he get the Southern drawl on point for The Walking Dead? Apparently, this star went out and ordered fried chicken and coffee to practice. Number 16, Charlie Hunnam. This guy stole every woman's heart as the motorcycle-riding bad boy, Jackson Teller, aka Jax, in the television series Sons of Anarchy. Because of his perfect portrayal of the all-American character, you might not have known that Charlie Hunnam is English. He was born in Newcastle in 1980, but we can all agree that Hunnam is equally as attractive with his native accent in the movie King Arthur, Legend of the Sword. Although most of us have heard of him now, many of us don't know how he got his start as an actor. I mean, a lot of us didn't even know he was from the United States. Hunnam was noticed by a talent scout at 17 years old while he was drunk and shopping with his brother on Christmas Eve. Number 15, Yael Stone. This actress's superb Brooklyn accent, as Lorna Morello in Netflix's Orange is the New Black, would lead anyone to believe she's a New York native. So you might be a little thrown off to discover that Yael Stone was born and raised in Sydney, Australia. Her dad, Harry, comes from a Jewish family, and his parents survived the events that took place from 1941 to 1945. But despite her roots, Yael is an atheist. She is also a women's and LGBT rights activist and spoke out about the misconduct she faced from Geoffrey Rush while filming The Diary of a Madman. Something you might not have guessed about this well-rounded star is that she's also an accredited yoga teacher and is an instructor for the Liberation Prison Yoga Program for Rikers Island. Number 14, Damian Lewis. Lewis is famous for his role as United States Marine Corps Scout Sniper Nicholas Brody in the television series Homeland. His American accent and general acting skills are so impressive in series like Homeland and Billions that he took home a Golden Globe and Primetime Emmy for the former.
If you're a fan of either of those shows, then you probably wouldn't have imagined that Lewis is actually from London, England.
His grandpa on his mother's side was the Lord Mayor of London, and one of his grandma's ancestors was a royal family doctor. If you want to hear the star's native British accent, then you should check out Wolf Hall, in which he stars as Henry VIII. Number 13, Henry Cavill. Cavill is pretty much the textbook definition for attractive, with his chiseled jaw, dimpled chin, gorgeous brown locks, and striking blue eyes. So it's really not surprising that he was chosen for the part of Clark Kent, aka Superman, in 2013's Man of Steel. But something that might come as a shock is that this all-American sounding actor is actually from Jersey. No, not the state, the bailiwick of Jersey, which is a crown dependency, and he currently lives in London. One of the shows you can hear his British accent on is The Tudors. All of us almost had the chance to listen to Cavill's accent as Cedric Diggory in the Harry Potter film series, but it was given to Robert Pattinson. Another role that Pattinson stole from Cavill was Edward Cullen in Twilight. Number 12, Michael J. Fox. This actor is mostly recognized for his teen idol days as Marty McFly in Back to the Future, Teen Wolf, and Family Ties. Despite his popular roles in American shows and films, Fox wasn't born in the United States. He was born in Edmonton, Alberta, Canada in 1961. His mom was an actress, and his father was a Canadian police officer. Fox is also of Irish ancestry. Although he's had a successful career and fulfilled life, there are some things this actor has struggled with. One of the biggest issues was his Parkinson's disease diagnosis. He's been dealing with it for about 28 years, and has become a significant advocate for research concerning the disease. Number 11, Simon Baker. Baker is most well known for his role as Patrick Jane in The Mentalist. His American accent is so believable that you wouldn't have guessed he's not from the United States. Baker was born in Launceston, Tasmania, Australia, and grew up in New South Wales, Australia. So there's no denying that this actor is a full-blooded Aussie, but it's certainly surprising since he's so talented at hiding it. Baker isn't just skilled in the world of acting, though. He's also a head-turner. He was chosen by DaVinci in 2013 to represent their gentleman-only fragrance in 2013. Number 10, Margot Robbie. This stunning actress has been nominated for an Oscar for her role as the main character in 2018's I, Tonya, and has portrayed characters ranging from innocent to completely insane. Perhaps Robbie is most well known as Harley Quinn in Suicide Squad. But no matter what part she takes on, there's no question that Robbie is a skilled actress. You probably didn't even know that she's from Australia. she spent her childhood on a farm and had to work 3 jobs at the age of 16 to make ends meet. But all of that changed when she began acting in 2007.
Robbie's talent and bold moves make her one of the most interesting ladies in Hollywood.
When she was auditioning for Wolf of Wall Street, she even slapped Leonardo DiCaprio in the face, which ultimately won her the role of Naomi LaPaglia. Number 9. Hugh Laurie. Laurie got his start as a member of the Cambridge Footlights, a theater group in college. During his time there, he met Emma Thompson, a now famous actress, and they dated for a while. Despite eventually breaking up, the two are still friends. Thompson introduced Laurie to Stephen Fry, another now known actor and comedian. The two ended up forming a comedy duo, simply called Fry and Laurie. He went on to act in movies like Sense and Sensibility, Spice World, and Stuart Little, but he is best known for playing the title character in the Fox television series House. The role gained Laurie a significant amount of recognition in America. He put on an American accent for the part, which was so perfectly done that the producer, Bryan Singer, believed Laurie was from the United States after watching his audition tape. Despite his impeccable impression, the star was born in Blackbird Leys, Oxfordshire, England, in 1959. Number 8. Andrew Garfield. This star has been nominated for an Oscar for his role in Hacksaw Ridge, and he even took home a Tony Award for the play Angels in America. He began as an extra and made appearances in some television series, like Sugar Rush and Swinging. Garfield received larger parts later on in movies, like The Imaginarium of Dr. Parnassus, Never Let Me Go, and The Social Network. This actor's big break came in 2012 when he scored the main character of Spider-Man / Peter Parker in The Amazing Spider-Man. In both Spider-Man movies, Garfield sounds like the average American man, which seems normal enough, especially since he was born in the United States. But his mom is English and his dad is from California.
When he was just 3 years old, his family moved to the United Kingdom, and Garfield grew up in England, so his natural accent is British despite being born in the States.
Number 7. Stephen Moyer. You probably know this actor from his portrayal of Bill Compton in HBO's True Blood. Moyer's amazing work at pulling off Compton's Southern Louisiana drawl could convince anybody that he's a native-born American. But this actor's roots are actually in Brentwood, Essex, England, where he was born in 1969. He began his acting career after graduating from the London Academy of Music and Dramatic Art. Moyer worked with the Royal Shakespeare Company, Oxford Stage Company, and National Theatre Wales before transitioning into television and the silver screen. Nowadays, Moyer is enjoying life with his True Blood co-star, Anna Paquin, who he married in 2010. Number 6. Seth Rogen. This Canadian-born actor is another one that you probably assumed was American. Nowadays, he lives in Los Angeles a lot of the time, but he also stays in his hometown of Vancouver. He's mostly known for comedies like Pineapple Express, Superbad, Knocked Up, and This Is the End. Rogen is also a writer and producer and wrote a rough draft for Superbad when he was only 13 years old. Besides making movies, this star has also been outspoken about Alzheimer's disease, the LGBT community, and various other things. Number 5. Idris Elba. Born Idrissa, this actor is known for a wide variety of roles in movies like Beasts of No Nation, Star Trek Beyond, and Thor: Ragnarok. His mother came from Ghana, and his dad was from Sierra Leone, a country in West Africa. Although he's mainly known for American films, Idris was born in London. Besides acting, Idris is also involved in music.
He's appeared in numerous music videos for people including Giggs and Fat Joe.
Elba also performed for Jay-Z's intro on the American Gangster album. Plus, he's a pretty talented DJ. In 2018, the star even launched Seven Wallace Music, his record label. Number 4. Ryan Kwanten. Another True Blood star that won everyone's hearts as the somewhat dim-witted but wholesome and caring Jason Stackhouse was Ryan Kwanten. Plus, this actor's good looks don't hurt. But you might not guess that the blonde, blue-eyed Southern charmer in the show is Australian in real life. Kwanten was born in Sydney in 1976. He received his degree in commerce from the University of Sydney. Kwanten started acting in TV series like Spellbinder and A Country Practice, Hey Dad. Then he played Vinnie Patterson in Home and Away, before leaving the show in 2002 and moving to America. The star was cast in Summerland from 2004 to 2005, and also appeared in movies like Flicka and The Rest is History. Kwanten is known as an easygoing guy, like so many Australian natives are, and he's been in some situations that many of us would lose our minds over. When he was 12 years old, he was surfing and narrowly avoided a hungry shark. The shark bit down on his hand, but he made it out with no severe wounds. Number 3. Rose Byrne. This is another Australian beauty that you might not have guessed isn't from the United States. Byrne has played in numerous films, including Neighbors, Spy, Bridesmaids, and Insidious. She also portrayed Moria MacTaggert in X-Men, First Class, and X-Men Apocalypse. Rose Byrne is widely considered one of the world's most beautiful ladies and is ranked in numerous beautiful women lists throughout the years. But Rose Byrne isn't just gorgeous and great at acting, she's also a fairly good singer. She sang her risque songs her pop star character, Jackie Q, put out in the comedy Get 'Em to the Greek. also starring Jonah Hill and Russell Brand. Number 2. Isla Fisher. You can tell in her interviews that she has an accent, but Isla Fisher plays it off really well in movies, like Bachelorette, The Great Gatsby, and Tag.
Despite her accent from Down Under, Fisher isn't technically Australian.
She was born in Muscat, Oman, while her dad was working as a United Nations banker there. Her parents are actually Scottish, and they moved back to Bathgate, Scotland, their hometown, when Isla was little. Then they moved to Perth, Australia, when she was 6. Fisher was brought up mostly in Australia, and has said that she had a wonderful upbringing and spent a lot of time outdoors. Although her roots say differently, the amount of time she spent in the country makes her feel very Australian. Number 1. Christian Bale. Famous from his work in films like The Dark Knight, American Hustle, and American Psycho, Christian Bale is a household name.
He has taken on all types of roles and played characters with numerous different accents, from the American South to the deep raspy voice of Bruce Wayne in Batman.
Bale is widely known for his extreme weight loss and gain to fit certain film characters, like the gaunt Trevor Resnick in The Machinist. So it's obvious that Bale is extremely talented regarding acting and his ability to transform into whoever he's playing. But his chameleon-like ways have left many Americans confused about where he's really from. Despite what you might believe, Bale was born in Haverford West, Pembrokeshire, Wales, in the United Kingdom, and he has a British accent. He spent much of his childhood in Surrey and Dorset, and lived in Portugal as well.
Today's featured comment is from Carol on our Things You Didn't Know About Khloe Kardashian video. Thanks for your comment, Carol. Don't forget to leave your thoughts below, and we might feature you in a future video. Hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.